You know, to be honest with you, this is the most important slide of the presentation. This is the take-home slide. And there is so much panic that out of panic and fear, we're starting to not do and do not what we can easily do. So, you know, a lot of illnesses, diabetes, high blood pressure, there's so much needs to be done. But so far, this viral illness, there are only 7 to 9 things one can do. So please pay attention, focus here. If you can take a picture, maybe I'll send the presentation to you, or it's online almost everywhere. These are common points. You need to probably memorize them now if you haven't done it already. So what are the do's? Wash hands frequently. One item, if you need to remember, should remember all, but this is the most important, is wash hands frequently. We need to cover our cough and sneeze. Frequently wipe high touch, you know, common surfaces. We need to keep a distance of at least, you know, 6 feet from someone who you think could be coughing, sneezing, or who looks ill. So minimum distance is 6 feet. We need to, you know, wipe the surfaces, cover our nose when we cough and sneeze, and wash them frequently. And then when we need to, hand sanitizers are almost every place in business, keep it at home. Alcohol-based hand sanitizer, you know, 60% minimum requirement, so we should all have it. Now is the time that stores weren't having it. I think they're restocking them now, so please buy those. What are the don'ts? So most important right now is do not panic. We understand the confusion, lack of certainty, and there's a lot of panic and hysteria that does not help the situation. So please do not panic. One more thing which is very important, common cold is caused by coronavirus. So when we go with an illness, when they do a nasal swab, you might get a phone call, you have coronavirus. Coronavirus can cause common cold. It is not COVID-19. So please remember, if you heard the word, you know, somebody's corona, if it's not COVID-19, it's a common cold virus. So people are getting really nervous about this. So just remember, not every cold is going to be COVID-19. As of today and right now, masks are not recommended for general population, but for healthcare providers or someone taking care of COVID-19 patient, they need to put on masks. But for general population, as of today, mask was not recommended. Of course, large gatherings, we need to avoid those. If there's a birthday party, function, celebration, large gatherings, you should try to do your best to not attend those, because again, the purpose is to minimize contact with large gatherings where there might be, you know, there might be someone carrying the infection. Initially, we thought that COVID-19 would only spread when someone's coughing, and so those, you know, that's changed now. Even a carrier, that means you have the virus in your nose or throat, you may not have any symptoms, you can still pass on the infection. So that's why it's best to avoid large gatherings. Of course, sick contacts, that's common sense as well. Unnecessary travel. If you're going for leisure, at this time, recommendations, do not go. Of course, if you have a job interview, you can get away without it, then you have to go. Just make sure, take the sanitizer with you, take the wipes with you. Any common surface area, just wipe and just take precautions. You know, one last thing on this is, please, I request to everybody who's listening in the entire community, do not forward unverified information on social media. It's adding to the panic and hysteria. There's so much stuff out there. Some 20 years old, some 30 years old, it's presented as it's happening now. So if it's not verified, please do not share. There's so much panic when people are sending pictures of stores, long lines and stuff. You know, it caused fear in us. What's going on? There's nothing for me to eat. My child would die of starvation. It's not at this point as of yet. So please, you know, it's good to be prepared, but I think at this point it's adding more hysteria.